Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will understand about the input offset voltage of the op-amp, and it is one of the DC offsets that you find inside the op-amp. So this DC offset or the DC imperfection is the unwanted DC signal that you find along with the output signal at the output terminal of the op-amp. So if you see the datasheet of any op-amp, then you will find that three parameters related to these offsets are defined. The first is the input offset voltage, second is the input offset current, and the third is the input bias current. So in this video, we will understand about this input offset voltage, and we will learn what is input offset voltage and how it can affect the output of the op-amp. Now to understand this input offset voltage, let us assume that both the input terminals of this op-amp are at a zero potential. And if op-amp is ideal, in that case, the output of the op-amp should be equal to 0 volt. But actually, if you see, you will find some finite voltage at the output terminal of the op-amp. So let us understand why this finite voltage appears at the output terminal. So if you see the internal structure of op-amp, the first stage of this op-amp is a differential amplifier. So actually, these two transistors should be identical to each other. But actually, there is a slight mismatch between the two transistors, and because of that, both transistors have a different biasing voltage. So let us say this non-inverting terminal has a biasing voltage VB1 and this inverting terminal has a biasing voltage VB2. So because of slight mismatch between these biasing voltages, there is a potential difference between the two terminals, and this potential difference used to get amplified at the later stages, and because of that, we used to get some offset voltage at the output terminal. So now suppose if we apply the differential voltage of opposite polarity at one of the op-amp terminals, then we can ensure that the output of the op-amp is 0 volt. So the definition of this input offset voltage is the amount of differential input voltage which is required to apply between the two terminals such that the output of the op-amp will become 0 volt. So this input offset voltage can be a few millivolts for the general purpose op-amp, and it can be as low as 1 microvolt for very high precision op-amps. So for example, if you take the case of LM324 and LM741, the input offset voltage used to be in the range of few millivolts. While if you take the very high precision op-amps like AD8538 and AD8551, the input offset voltage used to be in the range of few microvolts. Now, like I said before, it is very hard to predict the polarity of this input offset voltage. And even if you take the two op-amp ICs which are manufactured from the same wafer, it is quite possible that both ICs have a different input offset voltage. So the manufacturers also used to provide the maximum value of this input offset voltage. So whenever you are using that op-amp, it is ensured that the value of the input offset voltage will be less than the maximum value. So that is being said, now let us see the effect of input offset voltage on the feedback circuits. So here we have an op-amp which is configured in a inverting op-amp configuration. So to find the effect of this input offset voltage, let us assume that the input that is provided to the circuit is 0 volt. So in this case, some input offset voltage will be present between the two terminals. And the same thing can be represented by applying the input offset voltage at one of the terminals. So here, this input offset voltage is applied at the non-inverting terminal, and the circuit will look identical even in the case of non-inverting op-amp, because whenever we are considering the input voltage as 0, in that case, inverting and the non-inverting op-amp configuration looks identical. So now let us find the effect of input offset voltage on the output. Now let us say the output voltage because of this input offset voltage is equal to VOO, that is a output offset voltage, and it will be equal to 1 plus RF divided by R1 times this input offset voltage. So for the given op-amp, if the value of input offset voltage is equal to 1 millivolt and the DC gain of this configuration is 10, in that case, the value of output offset voltage will be equal to 1 millivolt. Now in this circuit, suppose input signal of, let's say, 1 millivolt is applied at this non-inverting terminal, in that case, the output of this op-amp will be equal to 10 millivolt. So because of this input offset voltage, there will be a 10% error in the output voltage. And as I said earlier, it is hard to predict the polarity of this offset voltage. So the output voltage can be either 9 millivolt or 11 millivolt. So as you can see over here, the DC error in the output voltage because of this input offset voltage is function of DC gain of this feedback circuit. And as the DC gain of this feedback circuit increases, the error in the output voltage will also increase. And this error is very critical parameter when you are dealing with very small input voltages. For example, whenever you are using this op amp for digital to analog conversion, then it is required that the error at the output should be as minimum as possible. So to achieve that, either you should use the op amp which has a very low value of this input offset voltage, like 1 microvolt, or by external means you need to nullify the effect of this input offset voltage. So in the same example, suppose input offset voltage is equal to 1 microvolt, then the output offset voltage will be equal to 10 times this 1 microvolt. So the error in the output voltage will be equal to only 10 microvolt. While if your signal is equal to 1 millivolt, then the output because of this input signal will be equal to 10 millivolt. So as you can see over here, in this case, the error in the output voltage has been reduced by 1000 times. So in this way, by using the op amp with very low value of this input offset voltage, we can reduce the error in the output voltage. The second method to reduce the effect of this input offset voltage is to use the DC offset nulling circuits. And there are many op amp ICs which used to come with this DC offset null pins. So just by connecting the external trim pot between the two terminals and adjusting this trim pot, we can nullify the effect of this input offset voltage. So these are some of the methods by which we can either reduce or remove the effect of this input offset voltage. So even if you use these DC nulling circuits, then also it is quite possible that you will find some DC error at the output terminal. And this error arises because of the change in the ambient temperature, because this offset voltage used to get changed with the temperature, and usually it is defined as an offset voltage drift in the datasheets. And it is defined by the unit of microvolt per degree centigrade. So for general purpose op amps, this offset voltage drift used to be in the range of 10 to 20 microvolt per degree centigrade. While for very high precision op amps, this offset voltage drift used to be in the range of either 1 or 0.1 microvolt per degree centigrade. So now let us see the effect of this offset voltage drift on the output of the op amp by taking one example. So in this example, we have been given this non-inverting op amp, and for the given op amp, we have been given some parameters. So as you can see over here, the value of RF and R1 for the given circuit is 9 kilo ohm and 1 kilo ohm respectively. And the input signal that is applied at the non-inverting terminal is equal to 10 millivolt. Apart from that, we have been given that the offset voltage drift for the given op amp is 10 microvolt per degree centigrade. Now for the given circuit, assume that the DC offset nulling is carried out at a 25 degree centigrade. So now whenever this circuit is operated at 75 degree centigrade, then we need to find the error in the output voltage because of the drift in the input offset voltage. So for the given circuit, first of all, let us find the output voltage because of this input voltage. So here the input voltage is equal to 10 millivolt, and the gain of this op amp is equal to 1 plus RF divided by R1, that is equal to 10. So the output voltage because of this input will be equal to 10 times this 10 millivolt, that is equal to 100 millivolt. Now for the given op amp at 25 degree centigrade of operation, the DC offset nulling is carried out. So there will not be any DC error at the output because of this input offset voltage. But let us see the error in the output voltage whenever it is operated at 75 degree centigrade. So whenever it is operated at 75 degree centigrade, then there is a change in temperature by a 50 degree. So first of all, let us find out the change in input offset voltage because of this change in temperature. So here we have been given that change in input offset voltage with temperature is equal to 10 microvolt per degree centigrade. So at 50 degree change, the change in this input offset voltage will be equal to 500 microvolt. So this change in input offset voltage will be get amplified by the DC gain of this circuit. So we can say that error because of this drift will be equal to this 500 microvolt multiplied by the gain of this op-amp, that is equal to 10. So the error in the output voltage will be equal to 5 millivolt. Now, like we had seen in the case of this input offset voltage, here also it is hard to predict the polarity of this voltage drift. So we can say that the total voltage at the output will be equal to this 100 millivolt plus or minus 5 millivolt. So output voltage can be either 95 millivolt or it can be 105 millivolt. So as you can see over here, whenever this circuit is operated at 75 degree centigrade, at that time you will see the error of 5% in the output voltage. So this error can be minimized either by using the op-amp with very low input offset drift, or just by maintaining the ambient temperature, we can ensure that the error in the output voltage will be minimum. So these are the some of the techniques by which we can reduce the effect of this offset voltage drift. So I hope in this video you understood what is input offset voltage and how it can affect the output of your op-amp. So in the next video, we will see few more parameters which are related to this DC offset, that is input offset current and input bias current. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.